Monopleti, Óscar Martínez, Radio Marca. Has anunciado tu retirada el otro día, el viernes, en una entrevista allí en un medio de tu país. Se decía pues un poco, ¿no?, que te habías encontrado en una situación de guerra entre el cuerpo técnico y la dirección, en este caso entiendo que es la dirección deportiva. ¿Nos puedes explicar un poco o contextualizar estas palabras, por si están pues mal traducidas por algún motivo?
Did you understand the question? Yeah. He's saying that you commented about your retirement on Friday to international press, and you spoke about how you've been in the middle of a war.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay, what did you mean by these words?
Well, first of all, my decision was strictly because of my family, because it's not been easy for me to organize life with three small kids away from home, even in this beautiful town, yeah.
Nada, a súa decisión ten que ver por razóns familiares, porque non lle é fácil organizarse con tres fillos en esta fermosa cidade.
And about sports reason, yeah, of course, they are always there. Well, you know, honestly, I expect that I will play more, you know, and but the main reason was always it's family, you know. They are most important thing in my life, yeah.
A ver, razóns deportivas sí que as houbo, esperaba xogar máis, pero a razón principal realmente é a súa familia que é o máis importante da súa vida.
I told all this, you know, so they could understand me. Well, to answer this question, yeah.
Dixo isto para que o entenderades mellor a resposta desta pregunta.
So, of course, it was very strange for Croatian journalists to see me not playing here and to see goalkeeper, like a third choice goalkeeper who started the season to play before me, yeah?
Para un xornalista croata que ya era difícil comprender que un tercer porteiro estaba xogando antes que él, entón por eso lle dou esta razón.
So they asked me about the reasons, and they also read Spanish press like they read here Croatian press, yeah.
Entón lle preguntaron polas razóns pola que non xogaba e os croatas tamén leen a prensa española.
Yeah, so they asked me about it, you know, and I said, you know, in football, you know, everything can happen, you know, but I said, you know, like, maybe that is the reason, maybe it's not, you know, but it's not mine to worry about it, you know, my main goal is to be fit to play, yeah.
Entón, lle preguntaron polo tema, el dixo que el non sabía cal era a razón, non se quería meter, ou a súa meta era estar en forma para xogar.
Luis de la Cruz, Diario As. Que recuerdo positivo, ou te llevas un recuerdo positivo desta etapa, ou crees que visto lo que ha sucedido era innecesaria en tu carrera?
What's the positive thing you take back with you, or from what you've seen, do you think this was unnecessary?
Well, the most positive thing definitely was game Saturday, you know, the emotions I had in that game.
Que o máis positivo que se leva é o partido do sábado, e as emocións que sentiu nese partido?
Because, you know, I felt really filled in my heart and my soul with the way how the fans made all this look really really big, you know, even though I didn't play a lot. Yeah.
Sentiu no corazón e na alma que os hinchas o fixeran sentir pois grande, aínda que non participara moito.
Alex Centeno, La Voz de Galicia. Una cosa, decías antes que los motivos de que te retirases ahora, que era por tu familia, porque no era compatible en esta ciudad y tal. ¿Te llegaron a ofrecer el club, pues llegasteis a hablar de poder continuar un año más?
You were speaking about how you haven't been able to organize your family life here in this city.
Yeah.
Has the club offered you another year?
No, but well, you know, I talk about it, you know, with Richard, you know, but and also I want to thank Richard, you know, for signing me here, you know, but you know, for me it wasn't like an option, you know, to sign, you know. I was pretty straight with him, you know, from the beginning, you know.
Falou con Richard e lle agradece a Richard que o fichara, pero que bueno, que non era unha opción seguir.
José Antón Fraga, Televisión de Galicia. Supoño que para él tamén foi unha sorpresa ter xogado tan pouco, non só para o xornalista croata, non?
For you, it was a surprise that you haven't played much, not just for the Croatian press.
Yeah, it is. Well, honestly, well, I told you when I was coming here, I'm really ready to help the team achieve the goal, you know, to stay up in the Premier League. That's the most important thing, yeah.
Que sí, que foi unha sorpresa para él, que él veu ca intención de axudar na medida posible de completar a meta da permanencia.
And also I told you, know, that I will need like at least 2 weeks, 20 days, 2-3 weeks, you know, to get completely fit, and that is what it happened in the fact, yeah.
Pensou que necesitaba dúas ou tres semanas para poñerse completamente en forma, e foi o que ocurriu.
And you know, but it was a coach decision, and I accepted because I knew that always I can get the chance and to show my best, you know, and I was, I think, doing pretty well on the training, thanks to Manu Sotelo, and I think I did good on Saturday.
Foi unha decisión técnica, el aceptouna, sempre pensando que podía ter a oportunidade de mostrar a súa mellor capacidade, grazas a Manu Sotelo, e o sábado el cree que ofreceu a súa mellor versión.
Alberto Gómez Barros, Onda Cero Radio. Xogou en Bilbao, que sabor de boca saca dese partido, a parte do outro día? E a parte do que nos está comentando, como foi a evolución? Houve algún momento no que el pois se viñera abaixo a ver que non chegaban as oportunidades?
After the Bilbao match, how did you feel? And then also, what's your progress been like? Was there any point that you felt low about not playing, or you felt down?
Well, definitely it wasn't easy time for me, you know, after Bilbao game.
Non foi fácil despois do partido de Bilbao.
Especially after Poro was ruled out because of the injury until the end of the season, and I didn't see my name in the titularis.
Especialmente cando se lesionou Lux, non viu o seu nome depois nas convocatorias ou nas alineacións.
I had a conversation with the coach, and
tivo unha conversación co adestrador.
But I wouldn't like to go out, you know, because with what happened, you know, what we said to each other, you know, but because, you know, I think some things have to stay inside of the dressing room. Yeah.
Non quere falar sobre as palabras que cruzaron el o adestrador, porque hai cousas que quedan dentro do vestiario.
The most important thing, you know, that I learned through my whole career is never to give up, to try to train even more harder, and then the God will reward you. And I think that is what happened to me. Yeah.
O máis importante o que el aprendeu é que nunca te rindas, traballa moito e sempre tes unha oportunidade, que foi o que pasou aí.
Solamente sin incidir, pero leva a impresión esa de que foi víctima dunha guerra entre dirección deportiva e adestrador?
Do you think you were a victim between
Well, I always try to watch, to see in my head like football, like it's a sport, it's a competition, you know. These things, what happen around us, there are a lot of things you are always happen, not only in this club, but everywhere, you know. I try to put them always on the side and really try to focus on myself, you know, because I think that's the only way you can play like I played on Saturday, yeah.
Él siempre intenta ver esto como un deporte, deixa esas cosas ao margen, se enfoca no seu trabajo, intenta dar o mellor de sí. Cree que eso é o que se notou o sábado.
Carlos Alberto Fernández, de Agencia EFI Deporte. Para un portero que solo jugó dos partidos con el Deport y uno solo en Riazor, no sé qué expectativa tenías en el último partido y cómo fue esa retirada con los compañeros, con el público.
Well, it was really, really a big day for me, you know, because sometimes, not only in football career, in your life, you have some moments which you remember till you die, yeah?
Foi un momento grande. Hay momentos na vida que vas recordar hasta o día que morras.
And I think I will remember this day until the end of the life, that I imagine how, like maybe 20 years ago or 10 days ago, that I imagine in my head, how will I imagine, you know, what will happen in that game, you know, I couldn't imagine it better.
Cree que obviamente esto vai ser unha das cousas que leva ata a tumba, pero que non se imaginaba fai 20 anos ou 10 días, de que non podía imaginar mellor.
I also start to cry, you know, it wasn't like manly, you know, but it had the emotions, you know, inside of myself, you cannot, you know, when they start to cheer, pletike date, and it was really, 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 really emotional for me.
Comezou a chorar, di que non é moi masculino, pero que bueno, que a xente gritando pletike date, pois que foi moi emocionante. Yeah.
Con la experiencia que tienes, ¿cómo has vivido todo lo que ha sucedido estos días, vamos, estas semanas, en el vestuario? ¿Realmente era un vestuario tan complicado? Decía Cani el otro día que en toda su carrera no había visto tantos líos.
You like these questions, ¿eh?
Gustamos estas preguntas.
No, well, I would like that to say it was easy, you know. It wasn't easy at all, yeah.
Mentiría se dixera que fora fácil, pero non foi fácil para nada.
But what I don't like, it's some things always have to stay inside of the family, yeah.
O que non me gusta é que hai cousas que deben de quedar dentro da familia.
And they have to resolve inside of family, yeah.
E se teñen que resolver na familia.
Only on that kind of way the team can raise as a team, yeah.
Esta é a única maneira que o equipo pode elevarse como equipo.
What I think, you know, that my opinion is like that inside of team the players should like take more responsibility, and the coaches as well, and to speak openly inside of team to resolve this problem, and not outside, so it doesn't look when you do that like outside, it doesn't look good for players, for coach, and for the club as well, yeah.
Que na súa opinión os xogadores e o corpo técnico teñen que tomar responsabilidade e falar as cousas abertamente, pero dentro do vestiario, non fora, porque falándoas cara ao público, pois, non, pois dá mala imaxe pa todos.
Because I think because of these fans, you know, who are supporting us and in every away game, at home game, you know, They don't deserve that, yeah.
porque os hinchas nos apoyan tanto na casa como fora e non merecen isto.
¿Es la primera vez que te ha pasado esto en un equipo?
Is this the first time this has happened to you in a team?
No, it happens in a lot of teams, you know. You cannot always have a perfect situation inside of dressing room, yeah?
Pasa en moitos equipos, nunca podes ter unha situación perfecta nos vestiarios.
But I think this is a good school, you know, like for everybody, so these things never happen again, yeah.
Pero isto di que é unha escola, unha lección para que as cousas non volvan a suceder.
Because, you know, when I was coming here, you know, I told to my agents, they are here today, you know, that it's for me the poor. It's not real like Real Barça, but after Real Barça, you know, I always imagine, you know, like the club, you know, like it's immediately, you know, behind them, you know, by you know, I want to say, like, how big is the club, yeah?
You're saying that Real Madrid and Barça.
Yeah, like the top, but
immediately,
yeah.
Está aquí, falou cos axentes, e claro que isto non é o Madrid nin o Barça, pero que o Depor é un gran equipo.
Yeah, immediately behind them, you know, like
inmediatamente detrás deles.
Yeah. So it's a big club and everybody should behave like that. Yeah.
É un equipo grande e temos que comportar como un equipo grande.
Hola, Steve, lo primero felicitarte por tu inmensa carrera y lo segundo me gustaría preguntarte de todo lo que tú has vivido, ¿con qué recuerdo, no me refiero solo en el deportivo, ¿no?, tanto en Spartak, Rostov, etcétera, ¿cuál es tu recuerdo más bonito de como futbolista?
What's your most beautiful memory as a footballer, not just here in Deportivo, in your footballing career?
I think it's like childhood, you know. We all have like best memories from my childhood, you know. So it's from my childhood club, my childhood dream was to play for Hajduk Split. It's, for me, it's the biggest club in the world.
Os mellores recordos veñen da infancia, do seu equipo da infancia, o seu soño era para xogar, era xogar para o
Hajduk Split.
Ese mismo equipo.
So the best memories are always, you know, when you start to play, when your dream comes true, also national team, you know, so that's the best memories I carry in my heart, and I think the one of them will be definitely game which I had on Saturday. Yeah.
Os mellores recordos son os da infancia, de xogar coa selección, lograr o seu soño, e obviamente o partido do sábado é un que vai levar no seu corazón.
You know, because also my son was with me, and it's a really really best memory you can have it in, especially when, yeah.
Estaba seu fillo con él, e claro, é un mellor recordo que podes ter.
Especially when we were walking down to the tunnel after the game, he came to me, "Oh, daddy, I'm so shaking because I'm so happy." You know?
Estaban indo hacia o túnel e o fillo temblaba e dicía, "Ay, papá, estou tan feliz."
Pleti baixe, pero nos quedamos no medio da tormenta. Dada a súa experiencia, como cree que se vai a resolver esta tormenta, sobre todo co futuro de Víctor Sánchez del Amo, polo que ele sabe?
He's saying you're leaving, but they're going to stay here in the middle of the storm. How do you think this is going to resolve itself? What do you think about Víctor Sánchez del Amo's future?
Oh, I don't know. It's well, decision is not in my hands, you know, but I think you know that he should lead the team with more authority, yeah, and he should lead the team with more bigger strength in managing the group, yeah.
A decisión non está nas súas mans, pero a opinión dele é que Víctor debe de liderar o equipo con máis autoridade, con moita máis forza.
Because this is one of the part, I think, in modern football, for not only him, for every coach, even me, if I will be coaching in my future, you know, it's managing the group, yeah.
Non solo él, pero incluso se Pleti algún día es adestrador, es una cosa importante para gestionar los equipos.
Because if you lose the group, then you are done with your job, yeah.
Porque se perdes esa autoridad de aquella ya te quedas sin opciones.
So it's up to the club, you know. So
es cosa del club.
¿Y cree que puede progresar como adestrador porque este fue el primer año como adestrador de Vitor?
Do you think Vitor can progress? This is his first year experience as a coach. Do you think he can progress from now on?
He can progress now. Yeah, he's a young coach, you know. I have also one of my three best friends are coaching, you know. One is Igor Tudor, one is Ivan Juric in Crotone, and one is Ivan Leko, is now in Belgium, you know. So we talk about it a lot, you know. But you know, the most important thing, like in every job, not only in coaching, is to recognize the talent in the person, you know.
Él cree que sí, que é un adestrador novo. Él ten seus tres mellores amigos son adestradores e teñen falado desto. Unha das cualidades máis importantes dun adestrador, pero non só dun adestrador, senón na vida, é recoñecerlle o talento ás persoas.
Because if you have a talent, you know, then it doesn't need so much, you know, to lose time for progressing, you know. You can immediately show what you can do, you know. For example, you know, my friend Ivan Juric is a coach of Crotone, and they now enter the Serie A from Serie B with the lowest budget in the Serie B. Yeah.
Porque se tes un talento, pues progresas máis rápido. O seu amigo, por exemplo, que é novo e tal, pues ascendeu a Serie A da Serie B.
So, I don't know. We'll see what will happen in the future. Xa
veremos o que pase no futuro.
Eu solamente quería facer unha para rematar. Cando chegou, bueno, antes fixo referencia a Richard, pero cando chegou deulle gracias a Deus e ao presidente por apostar por él. Como queda a relación co presidente deste político?
What's your relationship? How does your relationship end with Dino Fernández?
Fantastic. It was a really pleasure to work with him, with Richard, with Vidal, with everybody, you know, from the club, you know, from that point of view, I really felt happy because I always, in every moment, I felt they are behind me in every bad situation or good situation I had here. Yeah.
A súa relación é fantástica, tanto con Tino Fernández, con Richard e con Fernando Vidal. Sempre sentiu o apoio deles, tanto nos momentos bons como nos momentos malos.
Ok,
gracias.
Yeah, I just want to thank you.
Moitas gracias.
To the players, to the coaching staff, to the club, to the fans, also to my agents who are here, also to you, to journalists. I was really proud to play for this big club and I will always carry you all in my heart.
Gracias a todos os xogadores, ao corpo técnico, ao clube, aos seus axentes que están aquí presentes, a vos os periodistas, que levará este club no seu corazón.
Forza Depor, eh?